Hey guys, and welcome to another Cast of Salt.
Hey.
Hey! We have with us a very special guest.
It's not that special.
Hi Ben.
Hey,
how you doing?
Good, yeah.
That felt good. I enjoyed that.
You have to go slightly further up the thigh.
That's your job. You're
dude,
good at
he's
that.
So far away.
Adam, Ben, swap seats.
But then it just gets far too confusing.
Yeah, that's true. Yeah. Anyway, with us, we have Ben.
Yo.
Adam.
Hello.
Ben.
Yeah.
And Ben.
That's going to get really confusing.
We're going to get sick of that shit real quickly.
Ooh, great. How do you feel, Adam, being in the middle of Ben's and Ben's
Ben
and
Ben? The only fucking person here with the name starting
three
with
people
B.
With
fucking
the exact same
Ben
name.
Yeah.
Well, technically as well, your name translates to Ben.
We're the exact same names.
Yeah.
Exact
Benjamin,
same names.
Benjamin, Benjamin, and Adam.
Fucking three Bens and an Adam over here.
Welcome to the
Christ.
New podcast,
yeah.
Ben Cubed. I'm your host.
With Adam.
Special guest Adam.
Adam. We'll call him Ben for the meanwhile.
Yeah.
Because
if that would that make you feel better?
Ben 4. Ben Senior.
Ben the 4th.
You should have brought Alex Ben.
Alex Ben. Oh, God.
And called him Ben. Ben, 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 and Ben.
That's wonderful.
Right. We all sound different, so the audio
that's
podcast
true.
Should be fine.
That's
also,
true.
We all look vaguely different.
So. Vaguely different.
Vaguely
you
different.
Guys are like related or
yeah.
something.
It's like a color swatch. Like we start in the deep whites.
Yeah.
Move your way
am I really that white
red.
At the moment?
He's more tan than either you or me.
Yeah, I got sunburned yesterday. So we're moving through the passionate reds to the deep, deep seal skin black. Yeah. That's
like
it
I knew I was
intentional,
white.
Intentional
yeah.
setup. We
yeah, yeah.
we met this.
Yeah, no,
jeez.
Yeah.
It'd
be easy for the
time.
It was
the
easy
sun.
For the white test.
wait till you see it back on video, and you will absolutely agree.
Yeah.
Oh Jesus!
It's like I'm looking at it now. It's like yeah, we're not kidding.
All right. So mental note: sunbaking.
All right. I got the first question I could ask. Did you bring my comic books back?
you son of a bitch!
I still have Ben's comic books as well.
No.
Like with
any of the Blu-rays?
I started reading into the
Mist.
Serious House on a Serious Earth.
No, Serious House
good,
on Serious Earth. I haven't started reading. What was the other one with the Alice in Wonderland esque kind of feel?
Through the Looking Glass.
This is Batman, by the way.
Through the
Looking Glass. I don't like it.
It doesn't like you either. That's okay.
Normally,
didn't you say you didn't enjoy Joker either?
No, I enjoyed reading Joker.
What, as a
Killing Joke.
No, it was the one. It's the spin-off one. It's called Joker, isn't it?
Yeah. I think it's done by a guy called Andropause.
Yeah.
That's the one where they
that
give
one.
That Joe Blow as the main character, who's like one of his henchmen.
Yeah,
right?
Yeah. So it's based off like sort of after. The Dark Knight. So it's based off like Ledger's Joker.
Oh.
But it's a really interesting it's a really interesting art style too. Like it's like really real.
Yeah, the cover's like all kinds of fucked up.
It's good.
It's like
it's really good.
A shot of his teeth and his mouth and his teeth.
It's very cool.
Are you sure that you're getting that confused with Death in the Family?
No. It's definitely Joker. It's actually advertised in the back of Death in the Family.
Right.
I've just finished reading that because they're one of the books I've
You've got a few of mine. You've got
like,
what?
One of the many.
Yeah.
You've got four and three DVDs, I think. I gave most of them
back. I've still got a few. Because Leah wanted to read The Killing Joke, and then she hasn't read it yet.
You know, she can borrow my copy. When Ben finally returns it.
When I finally decide to give it back. Yeah. One of these days. Yeah. I still got a few of your stuff to read as well.
Yeah.
I'll give them back.
The Tale of the Missing Batman comics.
Yeah.
Just in rotation amongst the four of us.
Yeah. Someone's got one of them somewhere. I've got more you can borrow.
Seriously,
as well. I didn't bring them because I want mine back first.
I finished Endgame as well, and that's like really good.
Endgame was
that's actually one of my favorite Batman comics. That
I'm digging
read.
The next one, actually.
Have you guys read that yet? Have you got Endgame? So it's part of the Death of the Family, New 52.
Yeah. New 52 Batman's just not the same.
It's excellent.
Endgame is really fucking good.
I have not read or watched any 52 universe.
I've got
stuff.
Almost every Blu-ray, and you can have those as well.
See,
it's a couple of hours.
Aquaman, Throne of Atlantis.
That's really good.
Repping it.
I think that's still at my house. Adam gave it to me when everyone came over to film something, and then it just fucking stayed at my house.
And you're just like, it appeared.
Yeah. Damn it's it. Not gone yet. It's, some I think people. It's just sitting next to like fucking down that.
Yeah, I've got to, yeah. So everyone has something of everyone else's.
Yeah, yeah.
We're except for me, I'm the leech.
It's like the fucking, it's like a Mexican standoff of giving.
Oh, yeah.
Speaking of Batman, did you see that thing with Ben Affleck and Anna Kendrick? They're doing like a movie together.
Yeah.
And they hinted in a interview, well, they like sort of teased in an interview that he's sort of playing around, at least Ben Affleck is, with his own movie called The Batman now.
Mm.
Which is a strong title.
Yeah, no, it's
much
good.
Like the animated series. I hope it has nothing to do with each other.
Yeah. But he's a... Yeah. Well, apparently it's supposed to be sort of lightly based on The Long Halloween, which I'm super cool for. But
fucking sweet.
That's also the comic I've got for you, but you didn't fucking... I'm a library. You got to get mine back. He hinted that that maybe Anna Kendrick might be sort of like on the cards, possibly, to play Robin.
Excellent.
Oh, yeah. That's good. How does this work?
There is a female. There's actually two female.
Dark Knight Returns, chapters 1 and 2.
Okay.
They have a female Robin.
And
in
also there.
Carrie Kelly.
And there's also
Anna Kendrick
two
as
in the main canon as
wait,
well.
Wait. Hold on. Sorry. Mm. Anna Kendrick as in
Mad Men. Oh no! As
no.
Anna,
no,
no, Anna Kendrick.
God, no. As in
Anna
what's it called? That singing movie.
Yes.
Yeah.
Step up.
Yes.
Yeah. She's in it.
That's
in a
singing movie.
She's in
a whatever.
Comedian
yes.
stuff. She's. A, she, did a, she was a journalist in like a Middle Eastern.
Wait.
Movie,
wait. Pitch Perfect.
Pitch Perfect.
She's
that's
also
her. Yeah.
She's.
I'd say so.
Think
it's an interesting choice.
Look it up.
But yeah, they also released Amber Heard's outfit as Aquaman's wife for Justice League.
Yeah.
It looks pretty good. Cool. I don't know. I don't think I've ever seen Amber Heard in anything.
Yeah.
Apart from like Johnny Depp.
But, she's in Scott Pilgrim vs. the World as well.
Is she Ramona?
I've never seen her in anything except from Johnny Depp.
Which one
except
is she?
Johnny Depp, yeah.
She is.
No, not Johnny Depp, the movie either.
Oh, by the way, Stephanie Brown's another female Robin.
Yes.
Yeah, there's a few of them.
So yeah, so apparently that it's like hinted at, but I mean I only saw that from one source, so that could be just a load of
shit.
Well,
Long Halloween's fantastic graphic novel.
Yeah, yeah. I think that'd be a good one to do because it introduces a lot of villains one after the other, and it's got a really cool backstory. And actually, the copy I've got of it has like a full interview with the director of Dark Knight and Dark Knight Returns and Christopher Nolan. That was it.
Yeah,
I was like Nolan something. It's Christopher Nolan.
Are you
a whole interview
struggling?
Saying that, like that really deeply influenced the Dark Knight for him.
Also, so. Anna Kendrick is Scott Pilgrim's sister.
Yeah. Okay. Cool.
Yeah.
Thank you.
So yeah, apparently she's like sort of been hinted at possibly being, which I'm
awesome.
I think she's cool.
That does sound cool, but I'm struggling to picture it because I've never seen her in a particularly serious role. Well. Serious role as in...
Well, Robin's
a
not a serious
story.
Role. Your job is comedic relief, being colourful so people shoot you instead of Batman.
Yeah.
We all know
you're
it
the
to
target.
Be true.
Yeah, no, that's
who's your favourite Robin?
Oh, shit.
Oh. Wait,
there's so many. I was going to go Dick.
Dick Grayson's pretty
solid. Like when he goes
Dick Grayson.
Darkwing,
I
was just like, yeah, that's sweet.
I like Dick Grayson is Nightwing more than it was Robin, though. That's,
yeah,
I'm saying who's the best Robin, not
ooh.
Who is
the
best.
Who's the crazy one? Who's the one that dies and comes back?
Jason Todd.
He's my favorite.
Everyone hated him. That's why he died originally.
I absolutely love him.
Yeah, that's why
I like him because he's got such a weird and twisted and angry kind of story.
Yeah, he's a bit more realistic. Like he's
just messed up.
Well, you didn't have,
and
you
that's
know,
understandable.
You know how they first made him? I
because
believe
Joker
he...
killed... No,
Joker
killed
him.
His dad.
Yeah.
No. So when they first meet him, it's something like Joker kills his dad and frames his mum or something like that as a drug addict.
So basically, you're saying almost every Robin origin story is Joker kills some people.
I think there was
pretty
one of them. I thought it was Jason Todd. I thought Jason Todd was caught stealing, trying to steal the Batmobile's tires.
That's impressive.
Well, that was one of them.
That is Jason.
He managed to steal something from
that
movie.
That is Jason.
So he's trying to steal the tires off him. And like Batman catches him and then somehow
Kim
like,
Drake's
tires him.
This works.
You got balls, kid. Cool.
See,
I don't know.
Unpopular opinion. I really like Damian.
I was actually going to bring that up. That's the reason I asked this because like I've been watching heaps of the new 52 stuff. Damien has seriously grown on me. I've really enjoyed watching Damien.
The only reason I didn't go
like,
with
really
Damien is because I haven't seen enough of...
Yeah,
I've really liked it. I've been like...
shit to start with.
Yeah.
He's absolutely
he was so frustrating. And then I was just like...
And his granddad, so I've seen
his mom's cool.
Yeah.
Talia. Yeah. Goddamn Talia. Where does she hide that gun?
So, well, the next question is, who is your ideal person to play a Robin? Man or woman. It can be either. Can be Carrie Kelly or Jason Todd or whatever.
I don't know.
Chris O'Donnell for life.
Yeah, we've already had one. He was excellent.
We need another one. We need him to come back as Robin.
I like Jensen Ackles as his voice in Under the Red Hood.
Oh, he is, isn't he? He does. Yeah.
I think
he'd
be just a cool Robin. Or Matt Damon, if Ben Affleck's going to be in it.
Oh, yes, please.
Or you could get him to play Hush or something. Like, just something. That would be like, he has to be something.
It'd be like a comedian.
It needs to be a young
guy. It'd be like, I can't be freaking Matt Damon.
Yeah, they're like middle 40-year-old men.
50-year-old Robin.
With like shorts to here and like little green boots.
That costume does not work on your
hairy legs. Just...
So beautiful.
I think I'm sure there's been an SNL skit about this. Like already.
I reckon.
That's great.
If they got you brought that up. If they got Matt Damon to play, Hush. Even like Hush or
Hush would be hectic.
Or Talon as well.
Talon would be cool.
Like, I don't like Talon.
You don't like Talon?
No, he's so one-dimensional.
Well,
I thought it was all right. He's essentially like a metaphor for a figment of his past, essentially. He doesn't have to be too specific.
I kind of like Talon.
I liked him. I thought it was cool.
I don't care for him, but he's way more interesting in the
movie. He was in the movie, he was really interesting.
Yeah.
Oh, wait.
But I thought he was way more important in the comic book.
What Talon are we talking about? Because I'm talking about
the one that tried to convince Damian.
There's two of them.
Yeah, there's two of them. I'm talking about Bruce Wayne's brother.
He's not Talon. Yeah.
Okay, no, that's not
from
the
New 52.
New 52 Talon is Bruce Wayne's brother.
Sweet.
All right. Well, presumably.
You don't know for sure.
He's crazy, so the Wayne family sends him to a mental institute, and they just never see him again. No one ever comes back from
there. This is a great moment to be like, comic book continuity.
Yeah.
So many different things going on.
Like, this brother really isn't working out. All right, new universe.
Reboot.
I'm actually keen to start watching Rebirth as well. And all that kind of stuff.
Yeah. Actually, you got to get through Super Heavy first. That's a really good comic.
Super Heavy.
It's the one after Endgame.
Well, was there more in that run? I thought that was
Endgame was the last one. You've still got to go through like Bloom and all sorts of stuff. It's really good. It is. I don't want to spark the premise, but this premise is like revealing the first couple of things. So, like, Bruce Wayne dies. Like, Batman's dead. He's dead. Mm. As is the Joker. Presumably, he's also dead.
Well, yeah. Spoiler: Endgame does not end well.
If I remember correctly, and this is going to totally spoil everyone, doesn't Bruce Wayne come back with his mind completely purged of Batman?
He comes back not realizing who he is at all. Like, it's not even...
It's not just he doesn't know he's Batman anymore.
There's a really good monologue from Alfred talking to Superman. Superman's like, we need Batman back. We need him. And he said, like, you have no idea how hard it was for me to have to talk a man through all of the pain he's gone through in his entire life. So he has to tell him, like, his parents were killed. And he has to tell him from the start of his life what his life has been like. But as he got towards, you picked up the cow and you became Batman, Bruce Wayne's like, I don't want to hear anymore.
He's like, I'm done.
He's like, it's not me. That's like, not me anymore. I can understand that happened to somebody, but no, it doesn't feel like me anymore. So he doesn't want to know.
He just wants nothing of it.
Yeah. So Alfred doesn't time. So he doesn't time. So he starts. So Bruce Wayne starts working at a
taco place.
Chicken shop. He just runs like a chicken shack on a corner.
He's Bob's Burgers now. It's Bob's Burgers.
High class strip joint. Yeah. Where he's the lead act.
It's going to feel real bad after that because it's actually like a home for disadvantaged children.
God damn it.
Which I suppose could be a strip
terrible person, man.
I thought you were about to say home for battered women.
But yeah, so they actually have to have a new one in the meantime, so obviously,
is this when Commissioner Gordon?
Wayne Enterprises is taken over by a company called Powers, and Powers thinks like we need a new Batman, so they're going through all these candidates and stuff, and they immediately pick Jim Gordon, so they make Jim Gordon. Shaves his fucking moustache.
Old.
He's got
Jim
like,
Gordon.
Well, he was like a Marine. But so
he's younger.
It's cool as fuck. He's in like a regular outfit, and he's like a lot slimmer. But it's almost looking a bit like Rebirth, like it's the yellow outline sort of thing.
Oh, yeah.
Well, he's got no cape. He's got like a regular sort of outfit, but he doesn't use that to fight crime. Well, very rarely he does. He can't throw like batarangs properly. So he's essentially got a gun that fires them because he still has to, like, they can't do it. But the way they start him off is they give him a bat, like, robot.
It's basically Iron Man. It's like, that's Batman.
It's like an 8.5 foot tall robot. And they just chuck him in it. It's a great start to it. And they're like, are you ready to become Batman? And he's like, well, let me say for the record, this is the stupidest idea anyone has ever had. He's like, now where's my Batmobile? Let's have some fucking fun. And it's just him in like an 8 foot suit fighting dudes. It's really good.
That's pretty sweet.
All right. So we got one last Batman point.
I was going to say.
Because we've been talking about Batman forever.
Yeah. Last podcast as well. It was.
Really?
This is not our first Batman derail.
The Batman.
This isn't even a derail. This is. Hey guys, let's talk Batman from the get go.
Well, I thought this would be Batman. Aren't we trying to take over like Kevin Smith from Fat Man and the Batman? Are we trying to take his podcast slot? Fucking one up. Fuck you, Kevin Smith.
So, Cape Crusaders out 1st of November.
Yeah.
You're excited?
Yeah, it'll be good.
Adam West.
I'm looking forward to it.
Adam West.
Yeah.
Oh,
boom.
As soon as they're about to run, like, a chase after the Joker, and they're about to cross the road, like, Robin just starts jaywalking. He's like, no. He's like, there is a rule there for a reason. So they run up and fucking cross the street at the crossing. I was like, I love it.
Did they wait for the lights?
Yeah, they genuinely fucking stand there waiting for the lights.
And they've confirmed, I'm not sure if it's animation or comic book, but because Two-Face wasn't popularly done in the TV show, it's going to be more.
Yeah, there's one with Wonder Woman in it as well.
Yeah, 66 versus 77.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Super sweet.
I think that's supposed to be a comic and then it's supposed to be an animation film.
I'm honestly happy.
I'm cool
with
like either
we
or.
We live in the age where we can have our old shit revamped.
This is the age of nostalgia. It seriously is. Even like, fuck it. 1940s nostalgia, bring it on.
That was
like,
my favorite Batman movie.
Not 1940s.
It's when, so good.
If you judge it by how many times you watch a Batman movie, my favorite Batman movie is the 1966.
Some days
Batman
you just can't get rid of a bomb.
1 year old till about five, I watch it maybe like once a day.
You know,
I fucking love that movie. And it's still good. I got it on Blu-ray as soon as it came out.
I had a cassette of that. It was taped off TV.
Yeah, we had that.
I would say copy. So. It's got Batman and then Follow That Bird, the Sesame Street movie. Yeah. Right there. Back to back classics.
It's just like the perfect VHS right there.
What? I didn't even know why they got rid of that technology, honestly.
Like, I don't know what more you could want.
That's he re-recorded living. It and that's took all like the advertisers, all the ads out. So he's like, that means stopping the recording, waiting.
Wait for the ad to finish and recording
it
again.
Pro tip.
Perfect VCR.
We actually did.
Yeah, absolutely, man.
It's the kind of dedication
you pour into those things when you're a
kid. Into Adam West,
absolutely.
He deserves it,
totally
man.
Worth
he
it.
Really deserves it. For sure.
See, I'm just disappointed at work.
Beans like, everyone shut the fuck up, let's talk about video games.
No, he's got a good point. We probably should.
See,
actually, the Batman Telltale series is really good.
I picked up Arkham City on the Wii U for $8.
Was good?
It's all right.
One
so
word.
Far.
It's fine. It's fine. Okay.
All right, Ben, what the fuck?
I don't even know what to talk about anymore.
How's your week been,
just
Ben?
Like, what is any. Have you guys been up to anything other than Batman? Please tell me something.
I would say I reordered my comic book collection today.
No, that doesn't count.
Shut up!
It's all about Constantine there. There's no Batman. Some asshole has all my Batman comics.
Outlast 2 demo came out.
True.
Outlast 2 demo.
That is true.
Yeah.
What's Outlast?
You never played Outlast before?
What the fuck's Outlast?
It's a game.
Wow, bravo.
A survival horror game, I suppose.
Oh. Spoopy scary.
Ooh, speaking of survival, Overwatch.
Yes.
Yeah. There is
Halloween challenge.
It's called Dr. Junkenstein?
Yeah.
Revenge? Mm. It's Junkrat. Oh. He's Dr. Frankenstein.
He creates a bunch of robots
that you have to kill and stop from breaking into the castle of the whoever the
Tower Defense.
That's sick. And then
that's awesome.
So they put what's the fat guy?
Roadhog.
He's
Frankenstein.
No, he's Frankenstein's monster.
Frankenstein's monster. Reaper is like the headless horseman, like headless.
That's cool as fuck.
Headless Nick.
And then it's got Mercy as a witch, and she is the biggest pain in the ass in that game.
All right, we're gonna take a moment.
Keeps resin everybody.
Yeah.
and just appreciate Mercy's witches model.
Yeah. Because it is pretty amazing.
It's pretty cool.
It is pretty amazing.
You look at it and you're like,
without a
damn.
Absolutely. Absolutely amazing. But yeah, I've been playing that a fair bit.
Steering into the skid of free power. Just like, fucking go down this track.
But
I live in this track. Yeah,
to the Halloween special, the Halloween special of that is actually a lot of fun.
Yeah. Cool. Like, I love Lucio Ball. Lucio Ball was really
Lucio Ball was fun, but I prefer this one.
That's cool. Yeah.
The best thing about Lucio Ball was when you got to glitch out and get a character with an actual gun.
What, you just kill everybody?
Yeah. It's high noon. Bam, 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 bam.
We scored.
Boop.
Wasn't every game for a while had like a football game in it? Like as like a second thing? Because I mean like we had like, obviously there was a Griffball sort of started it off, and then they had
Griffball
was
fun.
They had Rocket League, but I think Rocket League
Rocket
sort of
League. Rocket League
is
a game on its own.
Because Warframe went through that too. Warframe essentially had Lucio Ball. About the same, about a week or two before Lucio Ball came out.
And really?
Yeah, it had its own.
Well, Lucio Ball was legitimately, hey, we know you like playing Rocket League. Why don't you run around and do the same thing?
Honestly,
like,
because it's the
same
game.
So fucking slow.
It's the same game because you don't have like the upgrades for the cars and this and that, but you have the characters. You run around the same
sort
of
skins.
Soccer field. Yeah.
See, I would have thought they would make more like Tony Hawk's maps on it, so you could skate properly.
Don't worry about
it. It's using analog. It's
sorry,
fine.
I thought, wait,
it's
start okay. again. Sorry. Wait,
it's like,
wait.
Stop! Stop right now!
So everyone start. Back to Batman.
We've done that before.
We've done that before, yeah.
We had a failed cast where we went on this Batman tangent. It crashed. It bombed. So we went and got some food, came back, and went on the same tangent again.
Didn't have, he's like, yep, back to Batman.
I will not be surprised if we somehow end up on Batman again.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
It's
right.
bound to happen.
So you've been playing the Halloween special
yes.
yeah.
in
Overwatch.
What else have you been doing?
Still Shadow of Mordor. I love that
Shadow
game.
It's really
good. I love the crap out of that game.
He just discovered how good the Nemesis system is, and I was like, oh yeah.
It's just sweet. The whole game. I've been upgrading as I've been going. Mm. Like, I've now got the shot where
the
you
bow.
Shoot the arrow, and then you teleport to where the arrow is,
oh,
and
yeah.
you knock them down, and you
yeah.
execute them straight away. That
That's good.
Just blows my mind. Like, I cannot get sick of that. I cannot get sick
well,
of
it's,
that.
It is a really so good. It's essentially like Batman meets like Assassin's Creed
yeah.
meets like Lord of the Rings. And it's wonderful. It's
it
a
is,
really
it
good
is.
Mix of why doesn't this work with this? Let's push them together.
And, it
and it's beautiful. It works
so
really well.
Makes
time
me happy.
For a piece of trivia about the game.
Makes me
Did you know it was backported to a PS3?
Really?
Yep. So to get it working, they took out the Nemesis system.
Really?
And
what,
you're like,
it couldn't handle that? Or?
It could not handle that.
And you're like, the only reason that we play the game is the Nemesis system.
Also, I actually think I would still play it.
It's
really?
A good game regardless.
I would still play it without the Nemesis system.
Also, it runs at like 14 frames. The textures don't load properly. The sound is so bugged that it ends up sounding like a techno track after like 5 minutes.
That's
just like
terrible.
A sound keeps looping.
Yeah.
Speaking
it's
of glitches,
beautiful.
I got one of the new games with, actually, by the way, Games with Gold this week. Not bad. Yeah, all right.
The last
Which,
one I
sorry,
got, I was super disappointed.
Got,
it was that baseball one, like super baseball.
Yeah, me and Adam.
Oh
whatever.
My god!
I started playing.
We,
and I was like,
he's a fact as well. The
god.
First time me and Adam filmed any like any
for an
any play,
brother episode,
yeah. we did
it's our pilot
the
episode.
Home run. We played that
yeah,
game,
that home
and
run.
It's a lot of fun. I love that game.
It's probably a lot of fun as multiplayer,
no.
but I was playing it on my own. I was just like,
Well, so, I would play
no.
it with stuff in the background. We played it. And we were like, that was really good. Thanks for watching. We turned around, and I think it was like a 52-minute episode.
No, yeah. See, this is me. I was like, okay, Ben, we need to be able to do a pilot episode. It might go out, we might not. We're just kind of having fun
working
around.
Out,
we're
yeah.
just seeing how the format goes. Because this was only a few, like maybe 6 months after
we'd started
our channel,
APoS,
so we
yeah.
didn't really have that much experience. Even me, I didn't have that much experience. Ben didn't have any.
Mm.
And we're like, okay, we'll just play this. And I was like, what's a good, fun game that we can play as a co-op game that'll only take like 15, 20 minutes?
Yep.
And Ben's like,
baseball.
I've played a fucking awesome baseball game that is that is actually fast. It's not an hour long match. It's like a 15 minute game. And we both play baseball. We love baseball. We can talk about that heaps. Not a problem.
Yep.
Fine. Great. That sounds great. Fucking no. It's 55 minutes later. And
yeah.
I'm just like, I just look at Ben and we're still recording. And I'm like,
fuck you for making me buy this.
It was like that.
I hate you.
Fuck off.
It was like that thing when you watch it, when you tell a friend like a movie's really funny. And yeah. This movie's like the best movie.
It's so good.
And then you watch it and you're not watching the movie. You're just watching them like, please laugh. Like, please find it. That will help me. Please make this funny. And like, you're just like, come on, do it. And there's just nothing. And I'm like, come on, Adam, this is a really good game. Like, get into it. And he's just fucking
I like playing it, but like, I found enjoyment in how it's not a terrible game, but it's just very average. And I was just like, I don't, fucking get it.
It's not good for camera.
No, no, it's not. It's not a pretty game.
It's not.
It's not an attractive game by any sense of the word.
Sorry, jumping. Games for Gold. Is that like PlayStation Plus for poor people?
Yes. So what they do is they have now that they have backwards compatibility out.
Respond to your.
They have a couple of like Xbox One games. And they usually like.
He knows what he's talking about. He's fucking baiting you.
Are you? You're a piece of shit. I'm gonna keep going. I'm staring into it. They also have now a 360 game, which is what I was gonna get onto. Yep. Which this week, this Games of Gold like month was, I think it was MX vs ATV Replay.
Oh, yes, that fucking game.
The only problem is that when it's been ported to 360, that when you get to the second level, the ground doesn't load. So you're like, let's get ready to go. And like, no, you don't fall off. No, it exists. You just like, you can't see it. You're like, where's all the cones? And you just fucking get railed all the time. And it's like, well, I mean, I got up to it. I was like, maybe it's just a game. So I re-downloaded it. Nothing. I think the port's just fucked. Yep. And no one's told anyone yet.
So...
It's just, Games with Gold. What the fuck?
I was like, that's really disappointing. I was like, yeah, it's free.
What am I complaining about? Yeah.
PlayStation Gloat, this month we get two real gems on it. Resident Evil remake.
Well, the first nice.
So, cool.
The first Resident Evil game?
Yeah.
Never been a massive fan.
I haven't played it. I'm just like, this is the first time. It's free.
Yeah?
Yeah, it's the
one is nostalgia.
It's one of those ones like, it's like a... It feels a bit like a King's Quest game.
Yeah.
Like, if you don't do things in a certain order, you just fuck yourself. Like, you don't have enough ammo for just to literally complete the bit. So, you have to know...
Exactly.
Like, I looked up a walkthrough because I was like, there's no way it's this hard. And you have to do things in a really specific order in order to get them done.
Yeah.
And there's, like, achievement for, like, do it in under 3 hours. Like, get fucked. There's no way I'm doing that.
And we forgot to mention the thing that ruins the 3 hour limit is tank controls.
Yeah, yeah, yeah. You got to turn. You turn and move forward with that. But... Like, you can't move and aim, and like,
it's, so you can only do one action at a time. You can only turn.
You can turn and run, but you can't do both. The only the first game they did that in was Resident Evil 5.
Yeah, no, 4.
Four introduced moving while shooting.
Actual control.
Four is the one that people also love as well.
That's really good.
And other one, Transformers Devastation.
I've been seeing that. Is that any good?
That's great.
Is that off the old
No, that's the cartoon one. Not the old movie.
I've heard nothing but good things.
Yeah.
It's a cartoon one. Man, it's great. Yep. 10 out of 10.
Yep.
Go buy a PlayStation to get
it. I actually played a couple of those Transformers games and they were really fun.
War for Cybertron?
Yeah.
War for Cybertron.
Yeah, I played that. It's really good.
Like, you could...
Really good multiplayer.
Yeah, I played the multiplayer, and it's fucking awesome.
Single player was pretty fun.
Oh, it's great.
And it's just like, it's very easy to transform into a vehicle, and once you transform into a vehicle, you still, like, control it really well. It moves around really well.
The fighting
system was really sweet.
The multiplayer was seriously fucking awesome.
Yeah, you have, like, three really different, good. Like, kind of different classes. Like, one's, like, a close guy, one's a long range, one's, like, an assault. Basic classes.
Yeah, yeah.
But you can still change into, like, robots and stuff. So, like, if some guy's, like, running at you, like, oh, fuck, you just change into a car and you can run away. You can just pop up somewhere else and...
Yeah.
Like, you have guys that will, like, jump. Like, you get, like, power-ups and stuff for doing certain things. So, the guys that... The short, fast guys get... If they hit max speed in their car... They get a damage boost.
Yep.
So you'll see guys in like F1s just cranking it. And they'll do a jump. They'll change in midair. Shotgun and kill a guy. And then they'll
change back into
and
keep going.
And I was like, that's fucking cool.
That is Transformers.
It's really good.
It is Transformers. That is what you expect.
And honestly, like they... It's funny because you wouldn't expect them to put that much thought into a Transformers game, realistically. But
it basically sells itself.
The multiplayer was actually really well thought out and really well executed. It's a really fun
game. That might have been the best bit, I reckon.
Yeah.
Nice, for sure.
Man.
It was good, man.
I wish I played the multiplayer now.
That's alright.
Other free game that I downloaded and was playing, Assassin's Creed China.
I downloaded that too.
It's not bad.
I already had it.
Yeah.
I was like, oh, I fucking bought that.
It's a really good game, though.
It's a good game.
It's there's a
bundle, though. There's three.
China, India, and Russia.
Yes.
India is really fucking good,
too. It looks good.
It's very, like, they're very pretty games.
Yeah, absolutely.
I think China, I've 100%, like, I've completed it like that. Yeah. I think I've got one or two more for India, and I haven't played Russia. Very pretty. Like, they're just really good-looking games.
See, just the phrase, Assassin's Creed Russia.
Yeah,
it excites me.
Oh, it looks really cool. Like
they're 2.5D.
They're 2.5. They're okay. So also, I downloaded that, started playing for half an hour. I don't know if this is an indication of how good China is.
And you missed out on.
But then I stopped playing it and downloaded Shadow Complex again.
I was gonna say
Shadow Complex.
You got
remastered.
Halfway through it, and then I was like, I'm in Shadow Complex.
$20.
Really fucking good. Though.
Yeah, no, but Shadow Complex is like, man, if I could get that physical, I would.
That game is fucking awesome.
Yeah, it was.
We owned that physical at one point.
No. It didn't come out physical.
It did. I thought it did. No, it absolutely did.
We didn't have a physical.
Oh, we downloaded on 360, and then a 360 version, a physical copy came out, and then a version for one came out, which is the remastered, which I now play.
All these games that we're talking about makes me think, like, I'm kind of craving some movement-based games again.
Yeah.
And did you ever play, like, Assassin's Creed?
Mortal. Like, the movement is the design of it.
Is what, like, movement puzzles, running around, doing awesome shit.
So, basically Mirror's Edge.
Yeah, exactly.
Mirror's
right.
Edge Catalyst.
I absolutely love Mirror's Edge. We don't talk about that. I have not played Catalyst, the second one.
I thought it was good.
I want to play it.
I'll give it to you.
Yeah?
Yeah, I got it.
Woo! I'm just sitting here going, all these games we're talking about.
My biggest issue with it is that it sometimes forces you into combat. And sometimes the combat's kind of shitty.
Yeah.
But like,
yeah,
it's like the first one as well. The combat
was
fucking terrible.
The only problem is they're like, now we are forcing you to do it.
Yeah.
It's still a fantastic game. Like, you can make it really difficult on yourself and turn off all assist.
Yeah.
So you just have to know what it looks like when you run at it.
Yeah.
But you can turn it on, and as you get better and better, like, you see more assist. Like, it's a good game. I really enjoyed it.
I just have this mental image. So Bin is notorious for getting lost, even in 2D games.
Oh, you're gonna have a bad time.
No. I was actually really good with Mirror's Edge. I don't know.
How come you're good with that, but you play a straightforward 3D action game?
I think that was the
you
best
get lost
part
in
Edge.
A goddamn car.
I know.
Oh, God, he's so
that
angry.
So
he's choking on bile. Like, I hate him so much.
That was like the first step of those like really bad loogies. That's like that 3-step program. It was like, and then it goes, and then it's like that solid. Oh God, like it's the 3-parter.
It's
like it goes 1, 2, and then 3.
It's everywhere.
Yeah, it was the first step of that.
So I have this image of Bin trying to play Catalyst with all the assists off.
Oh no, I would just die.
Mentally.
It's fantastic.
Just,
that
I really enjoy
it. He's just running into a brick wall.
That's all
he's doing.
I can see that. But yeah, no, it was good. It's what it is on the box. It's a fairly comparatively small, but it's a free world
Mirror's
Edge game. It's very pretty.
It's very pretty.
Hey, Bin, have you played Dying Light yet?
I have not.
Maybe you need to give that
Dying
a go.
Dying Light's fun as fuck.
Yeah.
I'm halfway through.
Dead Island meets Mirror's Edge.
Mirror's Edge. Yeah.
Yeah.
It's basically like, it's a zombie game, and I was like, oh, I don't fucking care about zombie games.
But it has a grappling hook.
And then it's...
Yeah. Wait, doesn't it have a grappling hook?
Both of them do. Yeah, I was about to say Mirror's Edge, the best part of that is running away from a bunch of guys.
Yeah.
And you're like, oh, there's a grappling hook spot. You just jump off a building and just go. And you just swing, land, and keep running. Yeah. That has it as well.
But basically, it's just like the style of zombies. It's like Romero zombies in daytime. And when it gets night,
all of them, and there'll be hundreds of them, will turn into
28 days later style zombies.
Yep.
They will hunt you down. And then these big ones, what are they called again?
The big ones? Right?
Yeah, like there's
volatiles.
Volatiles, and then there'll be these fucking huge 7-foot tall.
They don't. Well, it's not. They're like 6'5", but they don't look. They don't look human anymore. They have like giant claws, and their mouth opens like the Predator. And at the start of the game, for the first 2/3 of the game, almost unkillable.
It's just like run, like UV light,
keep running. It'll stop for half a second.
Yeah.
Because otherwise, they jump on you.
And they're actually
faster than you, and it's like tribal drums, and you're like, oh fuck. And you get that classic thing like in Outlast where you can run, and then like. The worst thing about any of those games is that right bumper where you just go.
You can like
that. And when you shot around,
running,
and you see they have amazing cinematic moments to that just by adding slow motion to that.
It's slow motion.
So when you turn around, it slows it down. So I go, thum, and you can see like 10 or 12 of them.
And
you're like,
and you just say, oh no.
And they're all faster than you. At the start of the game, when they run at you, the zombies at night are faster than you. So you have to use buildings to get away. If you just keep on the flight, they will catch you and kill you.
That sounds awesome.
It's a good game.
It's really fucking
the,
fun.
The DLC was all right too.
And it's mainly melee weapons. Like, I'm still like, it's one of those games that as I've started, you know, working longer hours, when you have like, this game's like 100 hour game kind of thing.
Yeah.
And I'm like, I don't have the time to dedicate to it. So I got like halfway through and I was like, oh fuck. And I just couldn't play anymore. I've got to get back to it.
Yeah.
But I'm still at a point, and I was like 20 hours in or something, and I still hadn't gotten guns. It's it's really melee based at the start. It's like, you can customize melee weapons and boost them, but they all have a very short shelf life, so don't get attached to anything. Like, you'll just beat zombies to death with it, and it will just break.
Yeah.
And also, I stopped playing it as well because Leah didn't want me playing it when she was in the room, because how you kill zombies is really brutal, and the sound engineering is so good.
It's really juicy.
You
hit cut an arm off, and you know, and then like
you can hit someone with a baseball bat in the head, and you can see their skull cave, and you're just like, oh, okay. Sometimes visceral. You have to kill humans as well, like enemy humans, and that's just as visceral. It's like fucking brutal. It's great. It's great fun.
I liked you wrote these things called Virales, which are like
the vast ones,
the super ones, 0.5, but they're just survivors that have turned into them. So they half turned. All do like parkour, so they will chase you up buildings and after and stuff.
So how do they turn?
It's an infection.
The thing is like the Virales are halfway towards turning,
right?
Which is a really cool thing. So when they run at you, if you kick them or hit them with a baseball bat, they say like, "Please no," or "I'm sorry."
Yeah.
And then they'll start screaming and run at you again. And then they're like, "Please don't hurt me! Please don't hurt me!" Like, "Oh, he's fine then." And then they'll just turn again and they just run at you again. So eventually, like, you have a guy on the ground, he's like begging for his life, and you just have to like beat
down.
He's
like, no.
It's pretty.
I can't leave you alone.
It's a really interesting sort of thing they haven't had in a lot of games where you're like, they were human. Like, these guys don't know it, but like, these guys are. They, like, when you hit them, it sends them a little bit back towards like sanity until they get that bloodlust again. So it's cool. It's a good game.
It's fun as fuck.
The DLC was huge too.
Yeah.
It's an entire new area. It introduces cars and stuff, which is quite fun.
You can hit zombies with cars. Yeah. Can't complain.
Who wouldn't want that?
Yeah.
And Dead Rising 4 is on the way out, so that's more zombie car action.
That's true.
For all your
I've never been a massive fan of Dead Rising, to be fair.
I played.
Yeah, it's a quiet taste.
It's a weird game.
Well,
it's fun.
People love it, and I remember 3 was one of the premier titles on Xbox One. Hey.
Yeah, it was one of the
titles.
I've got a Xbox, like a day one version of that.
Yeah, it was a day one title. Yeah, and day one. I played it and I was just like, it's okay, but it's just not my thing.
I get it with games with gold, but like, it's,
fair enough.
That's not really saying very much, I suppose. Saying, I would get it if it was free.
I would play it.
I mean, the only thing it's worth is my time.
Even that's pushing it, be honest.
All right, have we been up to anything else at all? Otherwise, we can jump into one of the topics that
I've been binging miscellaneous TV shows lately.
I've been binging Luke Cage.
Damn right.
I need to get into Luke Cage.
It's Netflix, Ben. You need Netflix.
It's like, goddamn it.
So,
we'll do it.
It's great.
So, what's our sales pitch to these two for Luke Cage?
I know who Luke Cage is.
It's Daredevil Season 1, but everyone is black. And
Spanish.
And that makes it 50% better.
Did anyone see that?
It's
that
great.
Thing that, like, it was like a GIF that somebody put up and said, after watching the Luke Cage trailer. And it's like, it's like a black guy that plays for, I think, the Hawks in the NFL. And the color balance is wrong. So the guy shifts down a filter. So he's really quite pasty.
Yeah.
And they shift down and he immediately comes black and he goes, and then walks off. So it's like, when I see the Luke Cage, like the Luke Cage trailer, and the guy's white and he's like, suddenly he's black. It's like, yeah, okay, help a brother. Like, immediately. Like, it's like, yeah, I'm a little more black for watching this. I like this. I can get into the street. Fuck it.
It's good.
Really good. Yeah.
But I have an argument with him that first 6 episodes, in my opinion, absolutely on point.
Really good.
Yeah.
Like,
they're fantastic.
Their next 7 episodes, kind of, if you liked it.
The episodes are out of it.
There's 12.
13.
Oh, 13?
Yeah.
They pump out the
whole season at once. So.
Oh, well, yeah, it's Netflix, so they just drop they just drop the season and go, off you go.
Hey, it's out now.
like binge away.
The only issue they have with that is a lot of their series, original series, have pacing issues because they drop it all with the expectation of that people will just binge it. And if we have two or three episodes of an hour show that are filler, no one's going to give a fuck.
Yeah.
Where if you did that and that mean that equals to 3 weeks of filler, people would
stop
watching.
Somebody said that about Orange is the New Black. I've never seen it, but I heard the same thing. Like, the only way to consume that show is by binging it.
Yeah,
otherwise, it's just, it's almost it's just so boring, but in one go, it's fine.
Yeah. Motherfucker, let me talk to you about pacing issues. This last seven episodes of Luke Cage, it kind of has like two highlights.
Oh, yeah.
Oh, there's the, okay. I agree with you that the first half of the season, the first,
I thought he was going to talk about Batman again.
Well, my Gotham, I mean, sweet Jesus, pacing issues of the show of the movie.
Yeah. Well, I know Luke Cage, the first half is definitely better, but I still enjoy the second half because I think I was that much invested in the show that I was
it was just like, it's
a bit slower, but it was kind of, that part of the show is a bit more origin story and a bit more background, a bit more knowing what is going on in the world. Yeah. And then the last couple episodes are like the culmination of the whole thing.
Yeah.
So I do get it. It's a bit slower. I was already invested, and this is my, because I am the odd man out. Like, I like Jessica Jones, but not as much as everyone else did. Everyone loves that. And
well, hell, it's still my PlayStation theme.
Oh really?
Yep.
Yeah.
I mean,
it's
a
nice thing.
It's a great thing.
It's a good show, but I just like, I found that it was like Luke Cage but reverse, where all the episodes that I didn't care about were all at the front.
Yeah.
And I was like,
at the end was really good.
Episode one, great. 2 through 6 or whatever, I was just like, where is the rest of this show?
Jessica Jones.
Yeah. And then it comes back in the second half, and you're like, this show's fucking great.
Absolutely.
But Leah stopped watching because she's like, I can't do this anymore.
Yeah, because
I just can't do it.
You're absolutely right. Until they bring in the purple man.
Yeah.
Like, they actually make him the bad guy.
He's in the piece.
He's in it.
And you get to see him in all his wonderful glory.
Yeah.
Yep. Jesus, David Tennant.
It did get
David Tennant's fucking great. And they had so many good things, but Leah didn't even see any of that.
Yeah.
So when people tell, why don't you like the show, all this and this, and she's like, I didn't even get to that.
Yeah.
And I'm like, that's kind of the pacing issue. I'm like, I can deal with filler episodes. Like, one of my favorite animes is Dragon Ball Z. I'm fine with filler. But
I'd still race Snake Wave for fuck's sake.
Yeah, that's terrible.
You know, the only reason I haven't finished the original series.
Snake Way's like 15 episodes.
You know, it took so long.
It's so bad.
Skip those, right?
Yeah.
I can't do it. What if I miss something?
There's nothing to miss. It's literally him running down Snake Way. That's like 15 episodes of that shit.
He does meet Princess Snake.
Which is also
like
filler, and it's shit. Like, that's garbage.
That's the only highlight.
What about those two guys in the Under Kingdom?
Yeah, those two guys wrestling each other?
Yeah, yeah.
That was weird.
They're like, well, this got homo right.
Was it the Kingdom of Losers or something? What they call, like,
yeah, it is.
Yeah, yeah.
It is.
Something. Good remembering on that one. No, I haven't been watching Netflix.
It's his hometown.
But I've been
watching
a fucking show called Downton Abbey Boys.
Oh god!
I don't think you realize how fucking sweet that show is.
It actually is pretty good.
Where did you get Downton Abbey?
I was watching Ash's Place.
Oh god!
On DVD, mate. Was that on the West Wing?
It was pretty popular though.
West
like while
good.
It was running, it was very popular. Downton Abbey.
No, it's huge.
It's
actually
story.
Like for its sins, it's actually quite good.
Again, on Netflix, and Leah has watched it start to finish.
When I was in the UK, like we were on a tour, and they were just like, and that's where they do Downton Abbey. I was just like, cool.
Well, they
moving up.
It's like that classic British thing. There's like 4 episodes in a series, 45 minutes. Episode.
Really?
No. British TV show seasons are fucking short as hell.
Is this no?
There's
this
like 12
that's
episodes.
Not Downton Abbey, is there?
Yeah, yeah.
No.
Yeah.
I'm not sure how
there's
long the season.
Four,
go
maybe
for.
Six at most.
Surely.
What
not.
Are you thinking
yeah,
of?
Yeah. No way.
Anyway,
it's the same as Fawlty Towers. Fawlty Towers only has like 4
episodes.
It's
12 episodes.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
While
Fawlty
you start
Towers.
Looking up
yeah.
that up, we can jump into the first topic of what we
no.
want to talk about.
Yeah,
what?
I have one last movie topic before we get on. What?
No.
You have got 10 seconds to tell
like,
us what it is.
Try.
And we
try
will
us.
Say if it's worth it. Ready, set, go.
Ghostbusters, the new movie was better than expected.
Ah.
Okay. Yeah, no, I can understand that.
Yeah.
That's
yeah,
it. That's
may,
it.
It wasn't a high bar to jump, let's be honest.
Well, I mean, it's better than Ghostbusters.
I probably won't watch it still then, but okay.
I probably won't watch it, but I'm perfectly okay with it.
I got, basically my sister tied me down and was like, you're watching this now.
Ben, okay. So I'm going to scroll here. tell me when we hit 12 episodes.
Of what, Downton Abbey?
This is all of the episodes of Downton Abbey.
Yeah, but it's saying per season.
There's four episodes per season.
Nine.
There might be maybe nine.
There's nine episodes a season. There's six seasons.
Okay.
I don't know. Yeah, there's nine episodes a season.
That's definitely more than four.
That's more than four, man. That's double.
It's less than 10, mate.
You can't even do a rounded up on that number.
Right.
Maths was never my strong point, mate. Park cars for
Ben, I think earlier on, either today or in the week, you mentioned there was some resurfacing on some SNES games?
Oh, yes. A classic Image comic. I think it's... Did I put Black Hawk
in it?
No. Total Recall.
I'm out.
What?
Something.
Total Recall the SNES?
I'm not sure. I was like,
well...
You know those things in the 70s, and you know that movie from the 80s. I think like, people in 2016
that was clearly the same
that.
Thing, right? I'm like, reading your notes here, like, your notes make no sense, man.
So, a classic SNES game from a guy in Image Comics. I'm pretty sure it's Black Hawk, which is basically Wolverine, but not...
Yeah.
I'm trying to... Have I seen that?
I'll find a picture for you while I'm talking.
Okay.
So... He went and said, look, guys, I want you to dev a game for my superhero. Go. Here's the money. Here's the funding. Boom.
And they made a SNES game.
They made a SNES game. And then they were like, all right, so how much does...
I was thinking you were saying, like, resurfacing as in they took some old SNES games and they remade it for now. But you're saying they literally just made a new SNES game.
No. They made this one 20, 30 years ago.
Okay.
But, as Ben will...
Yeah, so basically, and then he was like, all right, sweet. So how much do these cost to produce? What? Fuck no. And then it's been buried ever since.
Okay.
How many did you make?
It never got released as an original SNES game, and now it just got a digital release like 30-something years later.
Yeah, no, he just dumped the ROM on sign and be like, go for it.
Oh, that was it? Just like, not even... So, like, no. He made zero money.
Yeah.
Here's some money. How much that cost? Ah, fuck it. I'll take the loss. Okay.
No, so...
Cool. Who's Black Hawk? So, he's essentially like...
Where is it? Is it Black Hawks? I'm trying to find the picture for you.
Okay.
But yeah, so...
That's cool.
That came out and that kind of took everyone to be by surprise.
Which
I mean,
is
like,
sweet.
It's either that or everyone can continue to play No Man's Sky because that's about what we've got at the moment.
And no, there's one addendum to the story why I'm still trying to find this picture for you.
Yeah.
So some guy was like, hey, I'm going to make a repo cartridge of this game.
Okay.
And then went to sell it. And the guy who released the ROM's like, hey, you know what? I'm still an active publisher. Fuck you. Give me my money.
Oh, he like sued him for it.
Yeah.
Because the guy that made it, he released it for free.
But he's still like...
And he saw no profits from it. That's hilarious.
And he's like, nah, like, you ain't getting that
no
shit.
One, it's like, I'm not profiting from it, but no one else is going to profit from
no
it either. Screw you. No, that's cool though. Like, well, I guess the question that comes to mind is like, do you reckon there's more of those sorts of things that were made, but just never got released simply because of production costs or whatever, and then it's just would they potentially be released later on? Because now, like in the exact same situation, they could just release the ROM.
It's a huge market now, like that sort of 8-16-bit market.
Yeah,
like ever since, like there's been a resurgence of it, but I would think that probably the most prevalent one most people would know is Shovel Knight.
Yeah,
which was essentially an amazingly good SNES game. Like it was like a Mega Drive or a SNES game, but. Graphics wise and like even like design wise, like the interface was very like SNES-y or like very very basic, but it was a huge game. It got released on like almost every every platform.
No,
Steam,
it did.
Xbox One, PS4, it was on
Wii U,
it's on the Nintendo 3DS.
It's on Vita as well, if I remember
Vita,
correctly.
Vita, I believe it's getting a phone port, unless it's already got one. Sweet. So, like, that, there is obviously a market for it, but I don't know why. Did this guy bring it out, like, just digital, or I'm really hoping he made a cartridge? He's like, dust those fuckers off.
No, he still probably can't afford the production cost.
Yeah,
so
but I guess what I'm getting at...
It was Shadow Hawk.
Oh, that's fucking awesome.
Presumably he's a comic book character.
Yeah, from Image.
Drop your phone, even though it's got a crack.
Well, there's that.
Okay.
That's pretty cool.
Sweet.
So, I'm sure
he's very deviant arty.
Yeah.
Yeah, I don't mind him.
Well, once again, it was the 90s.
Year one. Did he get a reboot?
A few.
Wow. There you go. It's almost like Batman year one. Fucking
man, wasn't that a great Batman story?
That was good. Anyway.
But yeah, so no, but my point here is to say, like, wouldn't it make sense for, like, all these, even if it's like an EA game that EA chose not to release, just to be like, we've got all this old crap in the archives. Have it. Just here you go.
I reckon they go into other games. I reckon they go into other games. Like other games, like Well, there'll be like who made Shadow Mortal?
We were talking about this.
And why are you gonna interrupt it? You said EA is gonna release a free game. Have you meant that?
Or Nintendo?
Do you know EA? That was just an example. Who made don't give a shit.
No. Who made that?
I can't remember.
I believe a lot of the people that made it worked on Assassin's Creed.
Yeah,
so they would have very much just.
I even have that same search in my my history. Monolith Productions, from the last time we talked about it, I researched it before. We asked the same thing. Monolith.
Yeah. So, yeah, I would say there'd be a lot of games like that. I would guarantee bottom dollar that there'd be a lot of reused assets and controls from Battlefront that would be going into Battlefield 1.
Yeah.
Or alternatively, there'd be a lot of stuff that went from the unreleased. If you're talking unreleased, there's like Star Wars 13. And I would say that's probably going into whatever's coming next, I would say. Because there's so many assets from that weren't released.
Yeah.
That all you saw was trailers and stuff. That they had like a full game behind it and they were just like, hey.
See, those sorts of games, I can get them not suddenly releasing them simply because...
Oh, you mean like just releasing their assets randomly?
I'm talking releasing the game to say being like, something that they made in the 1970s or 60s or whatever.
It's archived, fuck it, have it.
They still have the files or whatever. They just never actually produced it. And
there's
then
a lot more methods for getting that sort of shit out there now.
Yeah, exactly.
Well, then like, having to produce it.
You don't have to produce
it.
You just put it on Steam.
A great classic part of it is...
a little bit of work around it, but yes.
Yeah.
Like Apogee and 3D Realms basically goes, look, no one's gonna fucking pay for Biomenace or the first two Duke Nukems anymore.
Here you go,
free to play.
Off you go. Yeah.
Welcome internet.
Well, even if it's not free to play, like they don't necessarily have to make it free. They just make it available.
Give me a dollar.
Yeah. Instead of making it, we have to spend $20 per cartridge or per disc to make this. Put it digital. Spend $2 on it.
That's sort of going the way that sort of, I guess, music artists, I sound like I'm 60.
Back in my day, they were called
the gramophone
musicians.
Boys. Fucking getting those, it's like how those gramophone boys work. But yeah, like there's a lot of people that release like EPs of stuff that they just never released.
Yeah.
Or like even remixes of stuff that never got onto anything. Like Tesla Boy has an EP that is specifically just remixes of one particular song they did that got very popular. Those remixes didn't make it onto any of the people's actual own CDs or their own stuff, so they're like, just release an EP of it. It was like $2 maybe, and they were just like, just have a sample of, they probably had the original on it and then they had all the premixes. There's a lot of places to do that sort of thing.
Basically we're talking about the B-sides of games here,
kind of. I would say so. Yeah. The stuff that wasn't, they didn't, well, I mean, Kendrick Lamar had an entire album called Untitled Unmastered that was just stuff that didn't make it onto Pimp a Butterfly.
Yeah.
Like, and it's a really good album, and it's quite long, and every song is called Untitled 1, Untitled 2. Like, he didn't even have fucking names for them.
Yeah.
But they're all almost, there's a couple of songs that are just backing tracks. There is one, I think, that's just the backing section to a different song, and it was all the stuff that he didn't put into it.
Yep.
But, like, it's all stuff that, it's just essentially a record of his creative process into making To Pimp a Butterfly. Yeah. And it was very cheap, I would say. It was probably $10, maybe. And it's good Kendrick Lamar, but it's stuff that he didn't ever really plan on releasing. So yeah, we're essentially talking about like video game B-sides, I would think.
I reckon that would be sweet. Like,
I'd be interested,
so
even just from a development perspective.
Yeah. Even from the community that we have now of like Greenlight and that, the whole concept
Early access.
I'm going to say it. Don't want to be taken out of context, but like the lowering of context.
Snap
Hitler
here.
Didn't technically like, do.
I will purposefully edit this podcast so that people can take it out
this
of context.
This will be the first question.
It's like the lowering of the standard of the gamers have of, when games come out broken and we go, okay, day one patch, I'm fine with that. Mm. That's just become something that we accept now.
Mm.
And releasing...
No. Something you accept.
Something... Well, I don't think anyone likes to accept it, but we just did. We're like, okay, this is the way the industry works now.
We didn't say, no one said it was unacceptable. So they were like, yeah, whatever, we can keep doing that.
I mean,
but can I point out, developers producing broken games is a norm. You've seen me play Dr. Jekyll and Mr. Hyde
But the thing is, they're games that make into popular culture because they're that broken. And that's it. This is our finished product, and you're like, this is terrible.
It was like Jason, like a Friday the 13th for the SNES. And it's just an absolute mess.
Oh,
but like it's like really very well known now because it's bad.
You mentioned that, but we're about to play that.
Are you? Yes. One second. Excellent. That's a great game. Like, have a fun time. He's off to fucking find it.
You want
to
be in on that?
yeah, like, but like that's how a lot of, like, I think managing expectations, I think, is the next step for video games. But I think that's the next step for all media. The only thing that's sort of getting away with it is music. Yeah. We were like, oh, we'll just see what it's like.
Yeah.
But like...
like, put it towards the camera.
The actual fucking... Come on, the Luigi. Actual thing. That's cool. I think one of the main things that video games and films... we're going to get back to Batman here. Like we said we fucking would. I think one of the main things they have to worry about is dealing with perceptions now. Because for the last couple of major releases of either major games or major movies, regardless of whether you liked them or not, or whether they were objectively good or not, the biggest problem is either people expect them to be this revolution of the medium, and it's like, oh god, like it changes everything, and if it doesn't, it's the worst game or best movie ever.
Actually call that Arkham. What's the third one? City
Origins.
Arkham Knight.
Origins
was fine. I liked it.
It was the weakest of the four.
Yeah, but it was still fine.
Once again, still fine.
First one, primo.
Great.
Second one,
even better.
Expanded on the concept.
Fucking brilliant.
Third and fourth were what? You have a tank now.
I liked four. Arkham Knight.
Let's
Arkham
go
was
into
great.
The past.
Yeah.
No, Origins wasn't nearly as good. And I think people, that was kind of the perfect storm of not having Mark Hamill. And all credit to the dude that stepped up and did the Joker in
Troy
Mark Hamill. Is that Troy Baker doing it? Fuck, he does everything.
Who's Troy Baker?
He's one of the most prolific voice actors in video games.
Nolan North.
Got an award for it, and he said, a lot of people ask me how to get into voice acting, and my response is always, learn how to edit, get a good microphone, and then wait for me or Nolan North to die. That was his award speech. So like he's there in everything. He's essentially like Nolan North.
Greatest one is all the Uncharted series. So Nolan North plays Drake.
Yeah, Nathan Drake.
And
he's from Canada, right?
Nathan Drake. Or
You said Drake. Yeah, Drake. Got my hotline bling. His brother came in. Man. So the latest one came in at they're like, we're now introducing Nathan Drake's brother that you've never heard of before.
Troy Baker.
Who's that voice actor? Him. That's Troy Baker. He's just like, what the fuck?
Bet they had fun with that.
No, they did. Yeah, they did.
But it's. I think that's a bit. I wasn't actually going to talk about the Arkham series. I was talking more about the last two Batman movies.
Yeah.
Mm. Batman vs Superman and Suicide Squad to a slightly removed extent. I didn't have much of a problem with either of them.
I still haven't seen
David Ayer makes one of them. He makes fantastic movies. Fury was one of my favorite movies of the last few years. It was fantastic. I loved Fury. And when Suicide Squad came out, I was like, oh sweet, fucking David Ayer movie about Suicide Squad. That's awesome. I saw it, and the only thing I could pick it up for, like, that was objectively bad was the editing. But it was because it had obviously come from a much higher rated film down to PG. So they had to like cut away from the particularly bad stuff.
Do we have access to the director's cut of this one yet?
Not yet, but I believe there's one coming out.
Yeah, see, I've drawn the line. I kind of wanted to watch it, but
I'd watch it like
it's cut up like that. I'm just like,
it's kind of disappointing. But I think a lot of people were like, it's going to be, you know, like the next revolution. Everyone's expecting like the Avengers level of good stuff. But we've had the Avengers. So you can't expect everything to be mind-blowing or fantastic.
Yeah.
It was the same with, like, if you're talking about video games, and Adam just brought up, like, very briefly brought up No Man's Sky, and I'm sure we're going to get to that because of all the Steam stuff that's been going on about it.
Yeah,
but a lot of people expected, and to be fair, quite a bit of it is stuff that they were like, it's going to be great because they said stuff that didn't exist in the game. The game by itself, there's not a lot to do with it, but that's not necessarily, like, a game-breaking quality. There's a lot of games that there's not much to do with, but it's everyone's like, this is the worst game ever. Oh, God, I spent so much fucking money on this. And it's the same with Division. Yeah. Like, the Division's not a bad game. I mean, it's broken a little bit from patches recently, but it's not a bad game. It's just that it's hyped, not only by the public, but by the developers. So I think the developers need to rein that back a little bit and be like, just fucking, like, take a step back, relax, it's a game.
Yeah.
But we think it's pretty good. But a lot of people are like, oh, the developers said it's going to be the best thing ever. It's like, of course they did. They fucking made it. Like, they're not going to be like,
I just don't get your hopes up. 10 years of my life making this.
Yeah. Game of the year, boys. Wait for the discount. Like, they're not going to do that. They'll be like, fucking day one it. Season pass. Like, it's not going to,
wait for the discount. Just wait for the on
sale. Just get the game of the year, boys.
Didn't the Division suffer from basically not being Destiny?
I think so. Yeah. I mean, there's very rarely been a game out this year that I've enjoyed more visually. It's a beautiful game. And it looks really good.
The Division.
Yeah. It's a really pretty looking game. The problem is that they didn't go through what I think is the best part of Destiny, which are the raids, where it becomes a more complex task. You are completing things. Like, the first time I did Vault of Glass was really memorable for me because it was a game that essentially you just shot stuff until it died and then you put this here or you hack this, and that was essentially sending your ghost to it and then you protect the spot. That was essentially the majority of the complexity of it. When you get to stuff like firsting Atheon and doing the Vault of Glass stuff, it becomes a team-based game. You can't complete it on your own. You need to have good... It's like playing Left 4 Dead. It's like playing Left 4 Dead, but then playing Left 4 Dead with four people. On hard, it becomes a completely different beast.
Yeah.
I think the problem with The Division was that you didn't need anyone with you. Everything was, oh, well, he's a big bad guy, but he's essentially just got a lot more health. He's a bullet sponge. Comparatively to the other guys, that was it. That was as far as complex as it got. It was, he has more armor than him, and they're coming at you from this angle. It's like, okay, that's it? And he's like, yeah, okay, and we just shoot him. Like, that's it. It became a game of, I wasn't in a good enough position to rail on this guy long enough for him to drop.
Mm.
So I died, so I better pick a better position. That's as complex as it got.
Mm.
It's a great game when you get like three or four people going, because it feels like a survivalist war. Like, I can't remember what fucking mission it was, but me and two other friends were playing it. And we got stuck on this roof for about 45 minutes or so. We'd die, we'd go back, we'd start it again. And it was fundamentally flawed. Like, we weren't killing guys fast enough. I was like, you're not killing fast enough, bad luck. That's it. There was no other way. We were bottlenecked. That was it. But when we finally got through it, we started reusing our abilities to help each other and make ourselves a better unit. It became a fun game. But those moments are very few and far between.
Cool.
But I think it was brought out with people expecting that,
yeah,
which it wasn't, which is a disappointment.
So just a question around the whole hype component of things, and you're saying, yeah, the developers are hyping their own games.
Yeah.
Do you think that it would be better, or any of you guys, I'm not talking just to Ben.
Which one?
Yeah, no, make eye contact.
Just me. I'm talking to myself.
I'm talking to myself. Screw you guys. But do any of you guys think that it would be better for the developers to step back into, just go back to their parents' basement, do their work, and let the media deal with the hyping and the such, and then just be like,
you make a game,
you don't need to try to sell it yourself.
I think it should become more like how movies are done, which is you get one or two trailers and the game comes out and that's it. But they have like gameplay trailers, and then they've got the multiplayer trailer, then they've got the single player trailer, and they've got and I love the Halo series, but you look at like all the background Bungie stuff that happens before a game comes out. They talk about like the reload mechanics and how the game's designed.
Yeah, you see,
and it's too much information because people
are giving away too much.
People start putting links together that don't exist. They're like, oh, well, if that happens, that means you can do this, and how cool will that be? And they're like, oh, it sucks. They said it was going to be there. And it's like, they didn't. You thought it was. Like, there's a big difference.
You made this up.
Put a couple of trailers out, and that's it.
And just leave it
at
that.
People will make judgments anyway. Like, if you look at
absolutely,
like Star Wars Rogue One, people are like, oh god, this, you know. Some of the dialogue is finicky. It looks like shit. Or the first poster that came out looked awful. It's really bad. It was just her standing in front of like a beach and just said Star Wars Rogue One. I'm like, oh, that's kind of shitty. The poster that came out 2 days ago, I think, is unreal.
Is that the Darth Vader one?
It's gone back to the classic
Star Wars,
like Star Wars Episode 4, 5, 6 sort of thing, and I love it. It's really cool. It's apart from, I think, one of the very rare North American release posters, it's the only Star Wars trailer to use white as a background color rather than black.
Okay.
And it looks beautiful. It's really cool. It has that sort of hand-drawn texture quality that The Force Unleashed was missing out on.
What is it like, the classic 80s poster?
If we can find it, we might put it up on the video.
But it's, I think it's front page right at this point. But yeah, as far as that sort of thing goes, I think that they should just release a couple of trails and go for it.
I would argue that they should go further than that. I want them to take the same approach they do with novels.
What, it's just...
And say...
Comes out and good luck fuckface fighting in a library.
Yeah. Like... The title of game is coming out. Fucking done.
And just really? Out.
That's as far as you want it to go.
I want... Wow.
I feel they're very different mediums, though. Like... A novel versus...
I want
a
books
game. Are for pussies.
I like my books with bitches in it, bitch.
No, that's true.
No, I want a game that stands on its own merits. I don't... They don't need to push it. If a game is good, it will get around.
It'll be good, yeah.
Yeah, well, the only difficulty with that now...
The Carl Pilkington didn't approach the marketing. No marketing. Just put it in a store. Yeah, people find it if they want it.
I was going to say, no, there definitely needs to be some marketing to let people know about it.
Otherwise, like, they're like, fuck, Halo 6 came out.
Like, when the hell did that happen? It was like, a year ago.
The thing is, if someone goes, Halo 6 is out now, who's not going to get up and go buy it?
Yeah, but who's going to say that? who's saying that?
No one knows about it.
Yeah, we're very lucky that, I suppose you guys are very lucky, all my friends are,
shut-ins. What?
Not all of my friends play Xbox games.
More or less beards.
You guys work in an industry where there's a lot of people that play Xbox games and they play video games. So you guys talk about it a lot. And I'm at work. I don't remember the last time I talked about that sort of thing at work. So if I was by myself and I knew no one else, and it was just me. I'm actively searching out when's Halo 6 coming out.
See,
I may never know.
Yeah.
This is my only problem and you missed some with gems your statement. Way. Is you typecast me as an Xbox boy. God damn it. Glorious Wii U master race.
But like I missed out on some fantastic gems of games because they weren't advertised. So
like Vanquish.
Stop stealing it from me. An amazing game.
It's
and
one of
I've
best
never
games
fucking
I've
heard
ever
of it. It's made by
what?
Square Enix.
Vanquish.
It's a Square Enix game. It's fucking
great. Oh wait, no, that's the one with the color and it's like a very overdramatic cover.
Yeah, the cover is like 3D-ish kind of.
Yeah,
it's like a guy sliding. So essentially,
you slide around
and you can slow down time, and you shoot as many robots as you possibly can. Yeah. And it's amazingly fun. It's not got a particularly good storyline.
The boss battles
line,
are nuts, though.
But it's awesome. It's a really good game, and I totally missed it for like 6 years.
That's like a launch title for the 360.
Yeah, I got it in like the last 2 years of the 360 because I didn't know. I was like, Vanquish, the fuck is that? Was this like some dark
shit? It was like
shit,
a $15 game in the bargain bin, and you're like, okay, I'll buy it. And then. Honest to God, that game, it's got the worst voice acting ever because it's pretty much...
I want them to...
It's almost like someone took the Japanese script and directly translated
it
in English.
It
it's
Sega
so
game?
Broken.
It's Sega, isn't it?
Yeah,
it's
it is.
A Sega Square Enix joint.
Yeah.
Fuck.
It's really good.
Fucking great.
If you haven't played it, I'd recommend it. It's...
You have a 360, don't you?
I have like piles of 360s.
Yeah. Buy Vanquish and just play it.
If there's any games I want them to bring back to... Xbox One, it would be a remaster of that and remasters of...
They can just bring
Remnant.
A fucking 360 port
the
and I'll
Last
buy it.
Remnant.
Yeah, that's true. But I was going to say, like, do, like, a Ninja Gaiden, like...
Yes! That's literally what I was about to say. I was just waiting for you to stop for a second. I was going to be like, Ninja Gaiden.
A Ninja Gaiden
that is
box,
what I want.
Ninja Gaiden box remaster. Just all new fuck-off achievements. Finish the game only using the Dragon Sword. Finish the game only using the Nunchucks. It's like, it forces you to finish the game, like, 8 times.
Yeah,
but
I got the achievement for only, like, was...
Using the Dragon Sword.
Yeah, and then you were just like, yeah, I've got to play this
now
fucking game.
I've
got to
play the entire game again.
Yeah.
But they're great games. It's such a good game. And so the first one on Xbox.
That was hard as fuck, that game.
I
holy
wasn't
shit.
No, wait, wasn't game. The first one in this trilogy only on PlayStation 3?
No, it was
we
Xbox.
Played on
Xbox.
It was
Xbox,
on Xbox
original.
Because we had it.
Maybe
a mate of mine had
special
it.
Special re-release.
Yeah.
I'm thinking about this.
No, that was Ninja Gaiden Black.
That's
was
black.
Only on PlayStation.
Thank you.
Yeah.
And then,
that was
but then they did a Ninja Gaiden Sigma.
Sigma X.
X or something.
Or
there
Omega
a bunch
or some shit. I don't know.
But
Sigma
there
was X
a bunch
was
only on PlayStation, and then it came back onto Xbox as well.
So
and Ninja Gaiden 2 was on Xbox, and then Ninja Gaiden.
Xbox One was Xbox. Like, Ninja Gaiden 1 was originally just on the Xbox.
On Xbox, yeah.
Yeah.
And
a mate of mine had it.
That was amazing.
He had a hacked like Taiwanese Xbox, and he had it on the Xbox.
Yeah.
And I think that might be the game we played the most as our mate Jordan.
Honestly,
we played that game thinking, how the fuck do we get past the first boss? And first time being like, wow, I've very rarely played a better game where you feel more like
so
a
much
badass.
Satisfaction.
Maybe it rivals Batman for me. When you beat an entire room in Batman without taking a single strike and it's like perfect
it's like,
free flow and it's got perfect dynamic
and
you're like,
and
oh my god.
Count hit count like 150 or something.
And like the first guy you run up to, like you're on a wall, you throw three shurikens into a dude and then you just Y button and just cut some fucking dude's head off. You're like, I'm fucking here. Let's go. And you just rinse a whole room. And like, you come out, you're like, I'm not taking a thing. Moves, everyone's dead.
Some of it's those moves are awesome freaking game. Amazing. Like when you absorb the orb and then you go into like that cutscene mode where you knock someone into the air and then you just like fly across.
And then you push them into the ground and... But it's
I like when you zoom and drop and the head pops when you hit the drop.
Yeah, they, oh man.
There's so many games I wouldn't know. I wouldn't probably know about Ninja Gaiden had I not played the first one. I played the first one on a whim. So your system does work sometimes where you're like, I just picked up a game and I fucking loved it.
Yeah.
But it may not work for a lot of new developers. Like you would know when Bungie's got a new game coming out. You would know when Ubisoft, you would know when EA is coming out with a new game. But you've got like little guys that have never made a game and it's their first like foray into it. And everyone's like, ah, oh, fuck it. It's not like... Well, it can hurt them a bit.
How'd you hear about Super Meat Boy?
Super Meat Boy? I watched a Let's Play of it, I think. Yeah.
So we're not saying you're entirely wrong. We're just saying it's a flawed system.
Oh, yeah, no.
It's an interesting way to think about it.
There is no perfect system for releases.
It does actually create... for anything. I feel like that actually might create a much tighter knit community as well.
Yeah.
Because like if you look at book readers...
people share stuff a lot more.
You look at like people that read books.
You read books? I read books. Like, let's be best friends.
Well, no, like you say...
Book high five!
I read books. No,
you are just much nicer
son
people.
Of a bitch. You're just still comic books.
But like, that's you true. Can I can have really in-depth conversation levels. Once I find out they read something, like I'm in the middle of reading the Dark Tower series by Stephen King.
Yeah,
and I
choice.
Can have an amazing...
Wait, where are you up to in Dark Tower?
I am just started Wizards in Glass.
Good.
I love the Wastelands, but yeah. So like immediately, we can immediately start talking about a conversation. That's a very tight-knit community there.
Yeah.
Because they're not very well known. So like you're like, you may have gone through the same sort of realization that I love these books as I did. Not, I just randomly found them. Like, when was the last time you played a Call of Duty game that had a tight-knit community?
No. Can we rephrase that?
Nothing but cunts.
When was the last time you played Call of Duty?
God.
That answers it. God.
Yeah. I got Black Ops 3.
Oh, did you get that?
Black Ops 3 was good, man. That was a good fucking game. It didn't feel like a Call of Duty game, but it was fun.
Was that why?
I think
although it was a different game. Constantly, I never had my mic on. I was always, like, private chat with a friend. I was like, I'm not venturing into this. I don't want to know how many like people my mum slept with.
Your mum's a hussy.
Yeah, apparently.
I don't need that while I'm gaming.
Yeah, no, I don't need that.
I'm pretty sure the last one for me was Modern Warfare.
Yeah, Modern Warfare was good.
I what was the one that we both bought, and it was
Ghosts.
Oh, was that Ghost?
Yeah, it wasn't good.
That was like Ghost. Was that the one with the Eminem theme song? That was Ghost, wasn't it?
No, Eminem was Black Ops 2.
So did it feature much pottery making?
No, why? What's on that one?
He's
that
making a reference to...
You know what the sad thing is? You picked up on the reference.
What was the reference of what? I want to know.
The movie Ghost with... What's his name?
Oh,
what's
with Patrick Swayze.
Patrick Swayze.
There we go.
If I could bring anyone back from the dead, he would probably be my granddad. Wait, you thought I was going to say Patrick Swayze?
No, fuck clearly, him. Hitler, just so I can kill him again.
Fun?
Hitler,
yeah. No, that's why they do. See, a lot of people think that Hitler was the worst guy in the world, but he did something right. He did kill Hitler. He wasn't all bad.
Everyone has that one
redeeming quality.
everyone has that little like ray of sunlight. Hitler's
he
was
did
he
what everyone
Hitler.
Else wanted
yeah,
to
yeah,
do.
Yeah.
So
he killed Hitler.
In some ways, Hitler lived the dream. it was pretty good.
Is that the title of this podcast?
Hitler lived the dream. Yeah, why not?
Oh, great.
You'll get some immediate dislikes. Like, people will be like, 3 seconds in.
Go. All right. Moderator, what's
last
next
thing,
on the agenda?
The last thing that we're going to talk about, because we're like an hour and 10 minutes into this thing.
Wow. Okay.
So, Batman. I'm
no.
Right?
Yeah. PAX.
Oh, yeah. Cool. Oh,
you fuckers are going. I'm
so absolutely going.
I'm
going
to get a drink.
Cider's over there if you need it.
I'm
so keen for PAX.
Yeah, very keen. We've got all our flights and shit booked. And we have...
Are we merchandising? We should, like, organize some quick merch.
Not merchandising, but we are going to get shirts.
All right, so we're going to get, like, 6 shirts, all with Carl's face.
We're Ruz face shirts.
We're putting orders out if anyone wants one.
We are absolutely doing
except
that.
Except for Ruz's shirt, which will just be plain black.
He can just go have a regular APoS shirt.
Yep.
Everyone else gets a Ruz shirt.
Yeah.
What are you most keen for?
Well,
PAX-wise?
They I think, well, I entered myself in the Omegathon, and I hate that. You.
Please die in several
I have
fights.
No idea what it entails, though. Like, I'm just like...
I don't know.
They asked, well, I was just like, you want in?
I'm
like,
pretty sure you know if you're in the Omegathon already, but basically what it is...
Who the fuck knows?
There's a huge group of people and miscellaneous games. And so if you lose the games, you're out of the race.
Yep.
But if you win, eventually you'll be in a one-on-one match on the main stage.
Yeah,
at the at the closing ceremony.
Lots of different kinds of games.
Yeah,
yeah, like
board games, video games, card games. They might be like, guess what? You guys are playing Pokemon trading card game, or guess what? You guys are playing. I don't know,
Yu-Gi-Oh!
Fucking... Yeah, I'll be like, yes.
It's time to do.
I believe in the heart of the cards.
I say that.
Zoom, boom, straight to the Shadow Realm.
Hey, that's a nice card. Can I see it?
Everyone's just using their grandfather's... Oh, their uncle's deck? Yeah. Some with, like, animes and, like, using their uncle's stuff. This was my uncle's deck.
Well, no, that's his grandfather. No,
it is his grandfather? His grandfather. The one show that doesn't...
It's always, this is my father's sword.
Yeah. This is my uncle deck.
Oh, Blacklist the Sword.
No one must know about forbidden love.
Oh, Yugi, what are you doing here? But no, I'm digging the panels. Great. Hopefully they're as awesome as last year.
Who's at the panels?
No idea yet.
They haven't released the schedule yet.
But last year we had such great classics as What About Ethnics in Video Game Journalism?
Wonderful topic.
Which,
hot button.
No, it was a clickbait title. What it was about was... Why aren't there more multicultural people in video games?
Okay.
Oh, yeah.
Oh, it's like movies and whitewashing movies.
Yeah, you know, it was just like, this is... Oh.
Matt Damon's in that Chinese.
I know!
Speaking of whitewashing movies...
You know why?
Scarlett Johansson! God damn it!
Oh, yes, Ghost in the Shell.
Yeah. Matt Damon is the reason they actually gave an explanation, because at the actual time that movie is set, there were a lot of white people in China, because they're all mercenaries from Europe.
Yeah.
So he's actually not Chinese. He's Dutch.
Yeah, and it explains it in the movie as well. Like, it ties it into the movie to say he's a foreigner. He's not genuine. Chinese.
It's like the last samurai with Tom Cruise.
When Tom teaches the Japanese to be honorable.
What was the other one? Keanu Reeves one.
Responsibility.
Keanu Reeves.
Yeah, where he's like. Oh, I'll have to look it up and explain it to you guys later.
Wait, like an Asian guy?
Yeah.
John Wick?
No, that was that fucking...
Sweet Jesus, we forgot about John Wick!
What movie is that? I'm looking it up.
Look it up right now. Yeah. But yeah, there's a Keanu... It actually looks really, really good. It's like 12 Samurais or something.
Oh,
like that.
No, 47 Ronin.
What is 47 Ronin?
47 Ronin.
That's like an old school fucking...
It is, it's a remake.
Yeah.
Yeah, it's a Chinese.
Well,
yep.
Yeah,
okay. But yeah, like, Keanu
Reeves. In that movie, it is his responsibility to fucking, like, train the Japanese man.
You know what? You're like, wow.
Just damn, son.
Yeah. Yeah.
Well, they, but I was just saying, we're talking about whitewashing. Leah sat me down to make me watch one of the worst movies I've ever seen in my entire life. Mm-hmm.
Princess Bride.
Avatar: The Last Airbender.
Oh no!
She made me watch it. You'll enjoy. You'll enjoy how bad it is. And 20 minutes in,
I cannot.
She.
I was so angry.
I'm so upset.
I was like, I would rather turn this off. I would rather turn this off and watch Dragon Ball Evolution.
No.
At least they went for an adaptation.
These are the forbidden tomes which no one is ever meant to open.
Dragon Ball and Avatar took two of my favorite things ever. I'm not even kidding. Favorite things ever.
Them.
And just shit all over it. I cannot explain how much I hate
both of those
things. Do you
know the second one? M. Night Shyamalan came out recently and said number two is coming out. And I was like, fuck you. Fuck you.
I want nothing to do with it. Even if someone tells me, no, dude, it's good. I'm like, nope.
And answer to why this happened is, I have a theory. I've time traveled back from the future to shit on you.
That's a Shyamalan twist.
It's my life
goal.
Everyone's waiting for the twist, and the twist is it was bad.
I took such a good anime and just ruined it.
The prestige.
The twist. The shocking twist is it's not that good.
I'm not even kidding. I am.
That movie.
Mad right now.
Are you looking forward to Power Rangers?
I actually am looking forward to that.
Yeah, that's
speaking of
crash.
Good adaptations.
Well, we don't know yet.
I don't, we don't know, but honestly, if they ruin Power Rangers as well. I'm just.
Okay, look, dude.
I give up.
I hate anything that I've ever loved
and they remake it. I'm just like, nope.
There is nothing they can ruin with Power Rangers.
I love Power Rangers.
It was already pretty bad.
I hope they keep the schlock.
The schlock. I hope they keep the schlock. I hope they keep my schmigame.
But yeah, no, they can't get more downhill.
Oh, God damn it. But I am looking forward to that. Yeah, like, yeah. I am keen to actually watch that. That would be sweet.
Yeah.
Yes, you're right. We did forget John Wick.
Yes, no, fucking John Wick 2.
Yeah,
I love how well he can give a bad line. I guess that is like his superpower. That is Keanu Reeves' superpower. He's being able to deliver a bad line, and everyone's like, "Oh, fuck yeah!" Well, like everyone was like, "Oh, I've got a feeling, I'm back." It's a bad line. Everyone's like, "Fuck yeah, you are!"
Like, hell yeah, you are, Keanu.
Finally, we found a role where he doesn't need to act anymore.
Didn't he say, "Why don't you?" Oh, he's like, "I could kill everyone in this room. Why don't you just give me a gun?" Everyone's like, "Yeah, he's back." It's not a good line.
That's a terrible.
But like, you know, who cares? Like, it's, you know, like. It's what it is. Lawrence, it's a movie that absolutely knows what it is and how what it should
and
be.
What
and
it's
it
working
be
with.
Essentially, White Man's the Raid. That's as far as it goes.
Oh, God.
White Man's the Raid.
And honestly.
So, what? They're going to kill his pigeon in this one? What?
I don't know.
I don't think it matters.
No, he has a new dog. The dog from the end of the first one.
They're going to kill his dog again?
Maybe. I don't know. But to steal one of my friend's jokes on Twitter, he posted up. He's just like, "Yeah, absolutely, I'm a thief." You think this is all comes naturally?
yes, I bet it comes naturally
no
because
original
you're
content
white.
Of my own.
Basically, he's just like, all we need is Carrion Moss, and we can have ourselves a Matrix trilogy that we can all be proud of. Because Lawrence Fishburne also looks fucking great.
Yes.
He's chilling on that set. It looks awesome. I'm psyched. Like, I'm so. It was one of my favorite movies to have come out in like the last couple of years.
Yeah.
John Wick. I just loved it so much. I thought it was so dumb and so fun.
There's a lot of good movies that have come out like that, though.
There needs to be more movies
like that.
Raid 1,
Raid 2, Dread. They're all good, but they're like basic premise, just gaps and fun.
What is
that? That's a great movie. It makes a good movie.
What is that dumb movie? Shoot 'em up.
Oh, I love that movie.
That was a good movie.
Basically the same premise with comedy.
I keep forgetting. I did see that. Yes, he ends up shooting the person in the dick. Yeah.
This is the one where there's a sex scene as he's shooting people, and they're spinning around having sex, and he's just like.
Yeah,
firing
like,
on all cannons.
I reckon that goes too far. I like that John Wick's like, yeah, he killed his dog. Feel bad. Have fun. He's just going to kill everybody now. And they do such a good job of getting somebody into John Wick by not by saying like, you know, he's like an ex-Marine and he's done all this stuff. It's just everyone's reaction as soon as someone brings him up. They're like, that's John Wick's car. There's an amazing moment where he goes,
oh, shit.
Oh. And like, that's it. And you're like, oh. Because all these guys, you just watch this dude like murder six people and he's like, oh. And he just thinks, I'm fucking dead. And you can tell, and everyone's like, okay, so he's a badass. So you don't have to show
you don't
it.
Have to
you just have to show
it,
everyone's reaction to knowing that this guy fucked with John Wick. Like, well, we're all going to fucking die
Some of the greatest scenes in that is when he's just like, oh, hey, Monty, where's my car at? Some punk drove it away. Cool, thanks, Monty. I'll be back later.
Yeah.
Goes away.
Or like, yeah.
Another one that does a great transporter.
Yeah, transporter.
Oh, the original one?
All three of them.
All three of them. It's more than three.
Don't
they're
bring amazing. Three into this. Don't bring three into this.
Okay, no, three was pretty bad. Three was the one where they couldn't leave the car.
Is there another one with? There was one that came out recently without Jason Statham in as well, and I was like,
that one I don't care.
That was four, I think. I was like, who cares?
So what? They were in like a bus, and when the bus dropped
below a certain speed,
Keanu's fucking steamboat right now, just hitting all the Keanu's. That's great.
But yes, Transporter is my favorite. Like one of my favorite scenes out of that is. Some of the bad guys, like, have him in a warehouse or whatever the case is, or, like, near a port, like a shipyard, and they plant a bomb under his car. And he gets in, he beats them all up, there's a few of them left over, he gets into the car.
I'll say, bomb flip, Crane grabs it. You've spoken about this on the
cast
before.
I absolutely love it. It's the best scene ever. It is such a ridiculous scene. Yeah.
But
I'm going to flip my car upside down. Hook it onto a crane and remove the bomb.
There are lots of movies going that way. Like, if you look at even like Fast and Furious. Like, it knows what it is now. It's, it knows, just like, it's like,
we're up to seven. We don't give a shit anymore.
Yeah, it's like, who cares? Like, they're secret agents now, and like
we're stealing
whatever.
We're stealing, like, trucks off the back of other trucks.
Or,
and these
she stole a tank. Or like I drove, like, my cars, like, between two buildings and then drove it down the side of a building and then did, like, a doughy on the ground. Like, it's like, it doesn't matter anymore. Because who cares? Really? Like, you're just here to see some cool cars and watch a car shift up 18 times in a row. That's all that matters anymore. That's all that matters. I want to hear that. Blah, blah, blah. That's all I need to hear. That's all I'm like. I'm there. I'm in.
I got what I came for.
There's a quote from the A-Team, which I feel summarizes Fast and the Furious.
Yeah.
The greatest. What are they trying to do? Sir, I believe they're trying to fly the tank.
Yeah, yeah. But that's all those movies are anymore. And I love that. I love when a movie knows what it is.
It's
they're the best
good.
Movies when they...
They are,
like,
thoroughly enjoyable.
You can take it the other way, too. You know when something knows how serious, like, its content is.
Mm.
So, like one of the ones that came out recently, I actually didn't think it was his best movie, but, like, The Revenant is a fairly serious movie.
Mm.
And
mm-hmm.
it comes off as a serious movie because it knows what it is. It knows that it doesn't need to make jokes.
Wasn't
it doesn't
just
need to be super serious, but the content is very extreme.
Wasn't it just Oscar bait, to be honest?
Pretty much. But it was good. I really enjoyed it, but it's...
Lee, it's like, I'm getting this fucking Oscar. I don't know what I have to do.
I actually think he's done better movies than that.
That's the thing, yeah.
Most probably.
But hey.
Yeah.
It was a good movie.
That's the way the Oscars work, though. We're giving you this Oscar for this movie,
it's what
and which
do.
Was good,
yeah.
But... This is really for the movie you did three
it's
movies
for,
ago.
A lot of people think the Oscars is like for when you're due for an Oscar, rather
yeah.
than like
when
like you've been in the industry long enough, we'll
give you an Oscar for it.
Like the woman that played, I was trying to think of a movie the other night and I still can't remember what the movie is. Maybe someone can help me. It is a movie with Meryl Streep in it, which is probably already cut out half the people
like,
here.
Who's Meryl Streep?
It is with, and
the
it's
most
about
attractive old woman you'll ever see.
It's about
wait, isn't that Monica Bellucci?
But Meryl Streep is like twice as old as Monica. Carry on,
saggy Monica.
It was in. She's in a movie.
She's an actress in a movie.
She's an actress in a movie. Yeah, about a priest that like presumably touches a kid, and it's a very serious movie. And there was only I think one Oscar nomination from it. It was Viola Davis who plays. Amanda Waller in she plays Amanda Waller
in Suicide Squad.
And she got an Oscar nomination for it and she's on screen for about 8 minutes and they were like, Jesus Christ,
like
that
what?
Was good. But it was like, it's what? Like Anthony Hopkins in Hannibal. He's on screen for maybe like I think he's on screen for 12 minutes and he was the only one to get an Oscar
nomination
for that movie. So like sometimes it's like that's above and beyond anything like we could have expected. That's why you get it. But sometimes they're like, you're consistently good in movies. You just have to do enough movies that you get one.
Yeah.
It's just,
it needs to happen.
Well, yeah, it's like, we're talking about today. Like actually this is something I was going to bring up, the Nobel Prize that got released recently for literature.
Yep.
You know who it went to?
No.
Bob Dylan.
Ah.
The first Western. I suppose the first Western singer to get a Nobel Prize in literature.
Sweet.
Just from his body of work, not from anything specific. Just from
his
body of work. A lot of people hate it. They think that's like stupid. I love it. I love Bob Dylan music. Like
everyone
I think
loves Bob
he's,
Dylan.
And there's some people don't.
they're wrong.
No, I know. But
read YouTube comments. I'm sure you'll find someone.
But a lot of people like didn't feel like he deserved it, which is really like a question of what. But it's about like what's popular at the time.
Yeah.
Like. You're always going to get a nomination for an Oscar if you write a movie. Either it's a biopic or it's about Hollywood. Really, you're just going to get a nomination somewhere along the line because that's just like the movies that they like. But you will get the odd thing here and there. It's like 100 Sexiest Men Alive. I don't know why I went men.
Go with me.
It's about like what style is popular at the time and who pulls that style best off.
All right, so wait, Little Bit or Big Spoon?
Like Middle Spoon. Call me. Yeah. I'm a cutlery drawer.
All the spoons.
I am a cutlery drawer.
Stuck in the middle with you.
But yeah, like I think like that sort of thing. And I mean, we can relate that back to like anything. You can relate that back to movies. You can relate it to video games.
Like,
you can relate it to books. It's what's popular at the time is what gets most famous.
Yeah,
absolutely. Like, people were looking for a game like No Man's Sky and it got panned. And like Adam said before we started, that it now has the lowest Steam rating in history because it was so expected to be fantastic because it's what people wanted. And the genre was what people wanted, but the content wasn't what they wanted.
And what I love the most about this as well, this story,
is everyone should have just played Elite Dangerous.
That is
a good fucking game.
But also, not that, is that people are still as hyped as they were for Star Citizen. And even more so, because they're like, man, No Man's Sky failed, but Star Citizen. Star Citizen is where it's at.
Genuinely, though, did you see some
it
of,
is gonna
have
be
you
such,
seen some
it's
of the
be,
gameplay?
It's going to be fucking version 2.
Did you see some of this game, on the recent gameplay that
it,
came
like,
out?
It glitched and
no.
The demo
was,
glitched
was,
and popped out and
was
the textures
guy,
weren't loading.
It was a guy
and
that was lifting off from a planet, so like he was going back out into space, and he managed to hyperspace jump planet to planet. It looked amazing.
Yeah.
So he comes up, and obviously the gravity is really heavy, so he's like just cranking the engine trying to get off. He takes off, and like everything goes for like white and stars and all that sort of stuff. And as he pulls back in, you see this planet coming at him just at like a billion miles an hour. And he just cuts the engine and comes out of hyperspace, and it just drifts, and he's like, and he's just over the planet, over the surface, and just lands again.
Lands
in
perfectly.
One shot, just up. Change planets.
I wonder how
one
much
shot,
that's
like,
a scripted event.
Holy
though.
Shit! No, it was part of a gameplay gameplay showing.
Yeah, I know, but that can be scripted though.
After that, he was like just showing like planet hopping. Yeah. He also planet hopped into space and just took off. It was like, I'm just not aiming for a planet. I'm gone. And like I was like, that's cool. That's what people want. They want, and it's what people wanted with Star Wars Battlefront 3. It was originally like people were like, oh my god, there's like this amazing thing you can do, which was originally in like the first run of Battlefront 3 when it got canned.
What do you mean Battlefront? Like
Star Wars Battlefront.
The EA Battlefront.
Yeah, so the one before that. What they had was presumably, apparently they had, you can take off from the planet, hyperspace, into space, and have a space battle.
Like just
like
jump
you can go
straight,
one
jump
and
straight
just
into
jump
a,
one, two, boom, into
jump
space,
straight into a
base, have
space
a space
battle,
and come back down to the planet. Like that was that they said, well, you can do that. That is something that we have put in the game. And I was like, oh my god, that could be in the new one.
Yeah.
People want that kind of game where it feels like a seamless universe, like where you can just suddenly I'm in space, suddenly I'm on the ground. People want that, and I was like, oh my god, you can do that in
No
Man's Sky, and everyone's really excited for it. And
no,
you can, but there's not enough around that to make that worth it.
And also, the planetary physics suck. So
well, they're all
matter.
Very similar, and all the planets
no,
are kind of similar.
There is no planetary physics. That's
yeah,
the point.
Everything's Earth. Like everything's essentially just Earth. So,
anyway,
yeah,
fair enough.
Yeah,
we've had enough about space battles.
Okay,
we've covered off our topics.
I think we're good here.
Yeah,
we've gone for a solid amount of time.
I think that's it.
Yeah, thanks for joining
us,
Ben.
We should just stop timing these and see how long we have.
We don't time it.
we just go. Honestly, I think we just need a water gun when people are ranting, so we go something subtle, something subtle and off camera, like
yeah, it can be on camera.
So behind camera, we have Carl standing with a Nerf gun.
You just see random.
Oh, Jesus, my eye!
That's good. Yeah, it's what I don't think it should be like as far as like podcast stuff goes. It shouldn't be one that like you feel like you need to time.
No, go.
You don't be like, all right, well, didn't stop, finish.
Oh,
if there's like a
not.
Conversation that's continuing, you just might as well continue.
See, the trouble is that we normally ramble on about like how our week's been, what anime we're watching.
Yeah.
Like I haven't even touched JoJo.
Oh, yet. We didn't touch anime at
Man,
all.
We just went. Oh, you just saved that for Samurai.
We went. All
we saved that for fucking video games.
We just went Batman.
We just went.
Yeah,
Batman.
We went deep into Batman.
Just balls deep.
Balls deep into
Batman. I would say Bruce Wayne. Bite down, we're going in hard.
Well, it's also our second time we've done that in 3 podcasts.
So. Sure, next time we talk about something else.
Bane won't be the only one that breaks your back.
Jesus.
Not bad. Anyway, we'll leave it there. Ben?
Yeah.
Not that Ben, this Ben. Thank you for joining us.
Yeah, it was fun.
It was great having you on the cast.
I had a good time. I'm glad I could contribute to the Batman conversation.
I'm just happy there's a Ben with less hair than I have.
Yeah. You're getting there. It's okay. You're still young.
I think give us all 5 years and I think we'll be there.
I will rock being bald.
I'm well.
I will absolutely
You're doing
rock
all right.
being
You're doing
bald.
Okay. That is
and I think
okay.
5 years I'll still be about the same, but
yeah,
eventually.
That is a thick dish cleaner.
Oh, dude, so thick.
Look at that thing.
Touch it.
Okay.
Oh,
enjoy.
Man.
Enjoy
it's
it.
So good.
Oh, God.
Come on.
Deeper.
It's so weird. Like, you can fall asleep on that.
Yeah, absolutely good. Not it's even right. kidding.
Yeah, yeah.
My niece
Ben
has.
Does it every night. I said, Ben does that every night.
My niece actually has fallen asleep.
Just
fall like,
asleep
just
on your head.
On my shoulder. Fell asleep on my head.
That's pretty good.
Good time.
Anyway, thank you for joining us for this cast. Any questions, any comments, any requests, tweet at us, Cast Assault.
Please stop talking about Batman. Hashtag cost assault.
Talk about Batman more.
Check out our APoS videos on YouTube.
Yeah.
Like, subscribe. Again, requests. Let us know. We'll pander to your requests.
Yeah,
we'll see what we can
like
do.
Yeah.
Anything you want to spruik yourself, Ben? Being the guest?
No.
I like your beard.
Yeah.
Thanks, man.
That is a nice beard.
Thanks. I had to come back for work.
But so, okay. Any pithy advice?
Pithy advice. I was going to try to say something funny.
But I get
now you put me on spot.
It's not in me. Right.
Stay safe. Stay out of it.
Stay classy, San Diego.
Don't use crosswalks. Be like Batman.
Jaywalking is
that's
the
one. Yeah, jaywalking. Don't jaywalk.
Thanks a lot. See you guys later.
Cool. See ya. Huh.